Now let's go ahead and talk about relative maximum and minimum points. So a relative maximum is basically a high point, and a high point typically looks like the top of a hill. That point would be the relative maximum. So when we look at our graph, it's constantly increasing. And so there's never a point that you come across that's like the top of a hill that is a relative high point. And so we would say that we have no relative maximum, so it's not applicable. Now, for a relative minimum, we would think kind of the bottom of a valley, so it would be the low point. And so if we have any valleys or low points, we would call that a relative minimum. And again, there's no point that is lower than all the nearby points to it. And so we would say that we don't have any relative minimum, so that's not applicable either. So that concludes our analysis of the cubing function and its properties. Make sure you have a good idea of the name of the cubing function and what its function looks like as far as the equation and its graph.